And we're back. Hello, everybody. Dark Phoenix Gaming here, and welcome back to Assassin's Creed 2. Last time we left off was just basically a bunch of random side activities. I did a load of different assassinations and retrieved another seal for Altair's armor. And in between the sessions, I spent a bunch of time going around just buying whatever I could afford to spruce up things and just complete my collections of weapons and what have you. And I did a bunch of upgrades to Monteregioni here, to the point where now there's only like a couple of shops that we need to get up to level 2 and 3 respectively to get done, and the armor of course. But in doing that, I spent basically all my money, so we have a grand total of 392 florins left now, after all of that. And because I'm not patient enough to wait for the chest to refill with money, I will not be bothering to wait until I can get all of that done before I go do anything else. So there's still like one weapon, I think, or something like that. Yes, at the moment, we're still lacking the chest garden spaulder for the Hemischmidt set and the metal van braces for that whole set of affairs, as well as the flanged mace in standard weapons. And that is it. But we are also lacking the medicine pouch from the tailor. And like I said, I've upgraded the actual town a great deal, so we'll be making a lot more money. I think if I'm remembering right from when I checked, it was like 8,000 to 10,000 every 20 minutes or something, but I don't have the patience to wait for that money to refill so I can finish doing my upgrades and buying things. But other than that stuff, I also picked up a bunch of paintings, but some of the more expensive paintings that are in the price range of like 3,000 to 9,000 florins each, I couldn't afford, but all the standard really cheap ones in Florence, Tuscany, and Monteregioni I did get, because as I've discovered, the paintings are actually unique for each city, meaning there'll be a bunch more to pick up in Venice, which is where we're going this time, because the Templars are apparently messing around in Venice and such, so we have to head there to have a little chat with them. Means we're taking this mountain route. And yet, no webcam today. I kind of wanted to mix things up by turning it off for once. So that'll be a thing every now and then. I'll decide not to bother with the webcam. And you probably noticed by now that I sound a little different. Basically, I'm sick is what's going on. I have a little bit of a cold, and my nose is kind of sniffly, so I'm gonna sound kind of different. But I really enjoy this game, and I love playing the Assassin's Creed series, so I wanted to get on with it. Cape not effective in this area? Oh, that's just bloody lovely.
Leonardo! Ezio? What luck! I run into a bit of trouble. Let me see if I can help. I know how to fix it, but lack the means to do so. If you could just lift the wagon.
Okay, time for Ezio to be Superman for a second.
What is this thing,
eh?
It looks like a giant bat.
Oh, nothing. Just an idea I've been working on. I could not leave it behind.
What is it for?
Well, I shouldn't really talk about it. Beh, al diavolo. I can't hold it in anymore. Ezio, I think I figured out how to make a man fly.
Yeah, one of Leonardo's more come on, eccentric ideas right there. Then go ahead and tell me. I do hope it's Venice, because I need to get there. Yeah, we already know that from that guy that told us last time. That's right.
Venezia, such a beautiful city. So many sources of inspiration. Ponte di Rialto, Piazza San Marco, l'Arsenale. What's wrong?
We're not alone.
What's happening? Who are they?
Bloody Templars.
Why? What do they want with us?
I think they want us dead.
Yeah, that sounds about right, honestly. And time for us to play carriage driver. Oh, fuck you. Seriously. Bastards. Well, I do believe we have made it.
You're here for me, not you. And catch up with you later.
Yes. Now, get your sword out. Let's see. Oh.
I see him. There.
And unfortunately, we have one of the big guys. Who is along for the ride? So, I will.
Remember your fate.
I'm going to be counter killing here.
Carefully, men. This one.
Oh, come on. Now, let's murder the lot of them. With their own swords. Yes. Come on, just die already. Fortunately, I am not entirely incompetent. And can actually go up against those big guys if I do it right. Blade from him and kill him with it. The ideal solution, obviously. But now I need medicine. That went rather well, I have to say, considering everything we were up against. And would you look at that? Even horses come along for the ride. Followed the carriage all the way here, did you, boy? Or girl, I'm not sure what gender our horse is. And now we get teleported to an entirely new scene, and a bunch of side activities are going to be unlocked in Venice, no doubt. At least I assume that's what's happening here with the wibble wibble. And indeed it is. Wibble wibble is taking us to our new destination. Here we are. And I just want to mention something. just sort of on the side, because one of the things I have to admit that I really love with Assassin's Creed 2, and there's my money, one of the things I really love in the game is just the fact that there's a lot less of Desmond in it. I mean, I just, in Assassin's Creed 1, found all the pointless Desmond sections they stuffed in there, seemingly just to remind you that he existed and shit. I just found them kind of boring, honestly. They were just pretty dull, and every time one of them popped up, I just found myself thinking, why is this here? What do I care? And just waiting until I could get back in the Animus and keep playing some. They were just pointless tedium in Assassin's Creed 1. Whereas in this game, and I have played before so I do know this, while the Desmond sections exist, they're not so much shoved in your face and they force you to acknowledge that it's a thing and what have you, as they're just kind of there for extra flavor and pretty short overall. I think you only see Desmond like maybe two or three times over the course of the game, maybe, and it's better for it, I think, because I really prefer the sections in the Animus to all that Desmond crap. Now, yeah, I'm gonna climb a handful of these towers on the way to going into the city to my next destination. Sorry, dude, did not mean to rob you. Yeah, I am going to climb a couple of these towers. But overall, I'm probably going to save that for like a tower climbing episode or just a side activity one or something. I don't know. Just because it would probably take me a good long time to climb every single viewpoint that's available in Venice right now. And I do tend to like to climb all the available ones at once. It's just the way I tend to do the whole viewpoints thing in this game at the moment. But here we are, top of another one. So let's have a look-see. Now, do I want to synchronize any others immediately? Actually, barring the handful of viewpoints outside the city, I'm actually going to get all of them. I did not expect that, but there's few enough right now that I think there's nothing wrong with going after them all now. It'll be pretty quick, and I can do the side activities another time, as well as the Eagle Vision puzzles. Slays with wanton abandon. Dude, I pickpocketed one person. That is literally all the illegal stuff I've done since I got to Venice. Come on. But really, I'll just do this now, and even though I found that Eagle Vision puzzle, I'm not gonna do it just yet. There we go, I gotcha. Now, let us find our way up this tower. And yeah, it does actually look like, contrary to what I intended, I am actually going to do all of the viewpoints before I progress with the main quest, just because it's far less of a hassle than I thought it would be. Ah, here's my way up. And now here we are. Just look at this epic view. That's one of the things that I love the most about the viewpoints and just climbing these unreasonably tall towers that would never realistically be able to climb. Just the awesome views you get from up there. It's just so epic, and I love just gazing down at everything. Also, they're epic. Did I mention the epicness? Because they are very epic. Did I mention them being epic? Because they're epic. Yeah. We are going to climb all the towers. If I can find the way out of the city again, so we can go climb the ones out there. Faster. It could make for a nice shortcut. I'll have to do some climbing. And hurt ourselves a bit to get out, but what the hell? And this is Venice we're in now, so there is water literally everywhere. And it really is nice. I just love the contrast between the cities, that you can see how all the Italian Renaissance cities are just so unique, and they are an individual place, rather than just being another city in Italy, as a lot of games would do. It actually shows off how they're unique, rather than just clones of the same city or some such. And that's one of the amazing things about all the Assassin's Creed games, the ones I've played anyways, that it does a great job of showing off the uniqueness and how each place is special in its own right. And they do a great job with that, and I love it. But that's another tower. Dive down into the haystack and make an unrealistic landing. As again, hay would not cushion your fall like that, and even if it did, the way your character is falling in a lot of these makes it quite clear that you would be cracking your head on the edge of that cart if you actually jumped like that. So it is doubly unrealistic in that way. But you gotta admit, it's still kinda cool to just jump off these massive towers and land in some hay. It's just kind of epic in that way, and we all know that Assassin's Creed is all about the epicness factor. Screw realism, this looks cool, is basically their motto, after all. And I don't begrudge them that, because a lot of the stuff you see from them do look... a lot of the stuff they do in the game is very cool to watch. a little bit to get up here like that. We've got another tower to pay a visit to. And yeah, I was basically just jumping on those posts because I could. Just gonna head around and climb them towers, and then I will head off and start the main quest. I'll probably do a few missions in that, but then work on some side activities next time around, and possibly a few in this part itself, if the number of missions I end up doing is a little shorter than I'd thought. I don't predict that will be the case, but it very well could be. I've had it happen before. Where the missions are a little shorter than I think, and I just work on side activities to fill the time. Which I don't mind, because the side activities in this game are just so enjoyable to play through, and I love them all. That's one of the reasons why I have few, if any, complaints about Assassin's Creed 2 as a game, just because it's so enjoyable and there's so many things that I love about playing it that I just have so little I can actually legitimately complain about without it just being a gripe. That it's just such a good game. They did such an excellent job with this one. There's a reason why, to this day, of all the Assassin's Creed games I've played, which I should mention only includes from the first one up through about halfway through 3, of all those games, Assassin's Creed 2 remains my favorite, just because it's such a great one, and just looking at how they literally improved on everything from after the first Assassin's Creed game. Because, let's be honest, after Assassin's Creed 1 and Altair being kind of a bastard to everyone for most of the game, having someone like Ezio, who was, the best way I could describe him really, is a charming asshole. Someone who you know is kind of a dick, but you love anyways, just because of how charming he is. Someone like Ezio was really a breath of fresh air, in a lot of ways. And I just loved having him as a main character after Altair. And I'm sure a lot of people feel the same, that Ezio was just a breath of fresh air after someone like Altair, because he was just such a charming, sarcastic, playful guy, you can't help but love him. Even though a lot of the later games improve on a bunch of stuff and are definitely excellent, Assassin's Creed 2 is still my favorite Assassin's Creed to date, and definitely my favorite of the Ezio trilogy. Of course, when I finally get around to playing any of the other Assassin's Creeds on the channel, and actually show off a little bit more of them, since, as I said, I've never played more than, like, halfway through 3, then we'll see if that opinion stays the same. One of the later games might well dislodge this one as my favorite in the series. We will have to wait and see. But for now, this game holds the favorite spot. Now, two more viewpoints to go before we start on that memory. Hopefully it doesn't take me too long, but these viewpoints have been rather quick so far. Sorry, guys.
What's this all about? Come, friend. No need for aggression.
That will just climb a few more towers, and then I'll do some main quest stuff. Okay, almost there. No assassination mission. I see you sitting there, asking me to go visit the Feathers of Death and kill someone for him. The birdie will have to wait for his weekly supply of blood. Right now, I am climbing towers. That's Leonardo, isn't it? Wanting to see me. Well, he'll also have to wait. I have to climb towers. For now, there is one more tower. Oh, we're not in Venice, we're in Forli. Did not realize that. This isn't Venice at all. I'm an idiot, apparently. So if I remember the main quest right, we're not actually going to be staying in this city, because we'll just immediately move on to Venice, so I'll have to devote an episode sometime to coming back here to Forli and having a look around to do all the side activities and things, which we're not going to be staying for an extended period of time, but I do want to complete all those activities. I'll come back at some stage so that I can do all the activities. Just because, as I said, not going to be staying for long, unless I am drastically misremembering how the main quest goes. Which, as I've mentioned, I have played Assassin's Creed 2 before, so I do remember some things about the plot. Even if it has been like a year or two since the last time I played through it, so my ability to recall some of the details is going to be a little sketchy. But let's have a look at this last place, and yeah, isn't it just so wonderful to just gaze out at everything? And now, drop, and Ezio magically does not crack his head. Well done on that, Ezio. I hear cracking your head on the side of a hay cart is somewhat painful. Decent money in the chest, but we will wait on that.
Ezio! Here! Over here!
Just a minute. I have to loot a fishing boat. Because, of course. A bit more cash.
Ezio! Here! Over here!
Yeah, I see you, Leonardo. You can stop shouting. But I do have another fishing boat to loot. Just give me a second, I'll take that 100 florins.
Over here!
Yeah, hey Leonardo.
Thank you, Ezio. You saved my life. I did what had to be done. You would have done the same. I doubt it. Bravery is not my strong suit. I owe you a debt, brother.
Di niente.
Tutti a bordo! Fra poco si salpa!
That's our traghetto. Venezia waits.
Okay then, let's
Where's
get to it.
What pass? You don't have a pass?
You cannot enter Venezia without a pass. Who invited you?
Nobody.
Basta! No pass, no entrance!
Don't worry, Leonardo. I'll come up with something.
Don't just stand there! I need help!
Oh-ho, who is this now? Help the screaming woman back to the docks. Okay, then. Alright, see. I'll be having that. Now, let's row ourselves over. I'm coming, lady. Come on. And yeah, I, to be perfectly honest, do not give a crap about this.
Madame.
Oh, you're good. The ladies must like you.
Usually.
I wasn't looking to impress, only to help someone in distress.
Which is exactly why you impress.
Caterina Forza.
Auditore, but please, call me Ezio.
I know that name from somewhere.
I'm Caterina. Now, Ezio, we must find you suitable reward. Do you have any suggestions?
There is perhaps something you could help me with.
I'm all ears.
Please, Ezio, ask for a pass to Venice. Do not, for the love of God, ask for sex. This is not the time for thinking with the other head.
Yes, Signora. Whatever you say, Signora.
Well, that works too.
He won't trouble you anymore. I took care of it.
Thank you, Caterina.
Perhaps we'll see each other again. Should you ever find yourself in the city of Forli, it would be my pleasure to welcome you.
Oh ho!
I look forward to enjoying your hospitality.
Oh ho! So what? She's like the ruler of the city, or whatever they're called.
She's Messere. Had I known. It's quite all right, my friend.
Yeah, I guess she's like the ruler of Forli. I don't actually know what their rulers are called, so I'm not even gonna bother trying to guess.
Be careful, Ezio. Do you know who that was? My next conquest. I don't think so, Ezio. That's Caterina Sforza, daughter of the Duca di Milano. Her husband is...
Husband?
Si, her husband is the Lord of
Forli. Oh.
That woman is as powerful and dangerous as she is young and beautiful.
Wow.
Sempre come una donna per me.
Yeah, Ezio does not know when to quit. But I gotta be honest, that's kind of one of the things I love about him. That's how... He looks at something everyone else tells him is a bad idea and goes, nah, sounds great. Think I'll give it a shot.
Everything all right?
Excellent.
Better than all right. You're making amazing progress.
Hello there,
amazing
Desmond.
Is quite a strong word.
Then why are we stopping?
Prolonged exposure to the Animus can have, side effects.
Awesome.
It's nothing to worry about. You haven't shown any of the symptoms.
Symptoms? What symptoms?
Degradation of cognition, temporal hallucinations, multiple awareness issues, overlapping realities, you know.
So what you're saying is...
What we're saying, Desmond, is if you're not careful, you may not need the Animus to visit with your ancestors, which wouldn't be a bad thing, assuming you could control it. Up until now, though, no one has.
Lovely.
Subject 16.
We have safeguards, Desmond, and they kept him in the Animus for way too long, sometimes days at a time. We're being careful with you.
I hope so.
Anyway, I was hoping we could test out your skill retention. See if you've picked up some of Ezio's abilities.
I'm game.
Great. Meet me downstairs when you're ready.
So we get to do a bit of this, of that, just in the real world. Quote unquote real world. As I said, honestly more into the Ezio side of things, but the real world thing isn't that bad. They definitely improved on it in terms of how much it holds my interest from the one in Assassin's Creed 1 where I just wanted it to stop.
So what's the plan?
We're gonna see what you've managed to retain. Come on.
Okay.
Abstergo's out there, looking for us. They're better funded and better equipped, so it's only a matter of time before they find this place. We need to be ready for them when they do. I want you to activate the warehouse's defense system. I'll let you figure out how to reach the sensors.
Oh, come on. Not even a hint?
Open your eyes, Desmond.
Well, I suppose that counts as a hint.
Lucy? I'm seeing things.
Do the hallucinations last longer than 30 seconds?
No.
Then it's nothing to be worried about. It'll pass.
Okay, if you say so. Kind of disturbing, though, even so. And up here, we could potentially fall to our deaths. So isn't that nice? Isn't that just really stellar that we could potentially fall and die in the middle of a training exercise? Just the kind of thing everyone wants to know is a risk, yeah? Any button. Well,
so
I don't know where the any button is, but the space bar works.
You've picked up every single one of Ezio's skills. The adoption rate is fantastic. Another day or two and we'll be done.
Well, that's good to hear. Or not, depending on how you look at us. Apparently Horsey wants to visit Desmond. Okay, what am I supposed to do? Really, what am I supposed to do? Is there another button I'm supposed to press somewhere? Apparently not. But we can parkour now as Desmond. That's kind of nice. Oh, was there something else I was supposed to do down there with Lucy? I'm not totally sure. Let's see. Unless I'm also supposed to hit this thing. Yeah, I was, apparently.
All right, you gotta tell
me. I'm an idiot.
Why Ezio? Why Italy? I mean, we could have just gone back to Altair.
Yeah.
Followed him during his early years.
It started with 16.
Ah, good old subject 16. He repainted my room, you know. With his blood.
I've been going through his files. Vidic flagged a couple of his animus sessions.
Oh, another thing over here to press.
Different dates and locations. Ancient Africa, the Middle East. But towards the end, he became obsessed with Italy. I think he knew about the vault.
Vault? What vault?
A few of the later animus sessions are missing. And the sessions that are there... After everything the Templars put him through. After everything I put him through. It's all scrambled. If we hadn't pushed 16 so hard, we'd have the answers already. And maybe he'd still be alive.
Come on, Lucy, that's negative thinking.
So you're after the Codex and the Vault.
I knew you had an ancestor in Italy who was at the center of all of this.
Okay. Is that it or what? No. Need to find some more of those red switches to flip. Wherever it is the damn things actually hang out at. So, let's get back up here. And yes, there's one over here.
Hey, over here.
Hey, over here? That would seem to imply get down here. So give me a sec. And I will do that. And so, does Lucy want to chat now?
Over here. All right,
okay.
I think we're done for the day.
She does indeed.
You should get some rest.
Lucy, what happened to 16 wasn't your fault. You were just as much a prisoner as I was.
Thanks. Good night, Desmond.
Nighty-night.
I'm glad you're here.
Now, gotta go get some rest. And then continue on with the animus. The hell? This is kind of freaky, gotta be honest. Just seeing crusaders walking everywhere. And assassins. It's a little bit on the freaky side. Who was that? Looked like an assassin, but definitely female. And there haven't been any women assassins as far as I know. We're back with Altair, apparently.
Where am I? It's Acre. Altair. What the hell? Not even in the animus. Passed out. Just having some kind of weird dream. Going without sleep. That must be his target.
Target, yes, but not in the way you're thinking of. Yes, I do indeed know who it is. And get ready for some interesting occurrences, folks. And me failing at parkour even in dream sequence. even in dream sequences. Yes. Get yourself up there, Altair. I have no patience for your inability to parkour properly half of the time. And she clearly knows that we're here, so obviously not a traditional assassination target. But I'm curious, so let's play along. What do we have here? Let's have a look-see, shall we? We shall. We're shelling right now. Here we are. We way up, and here we go. Why, hello there.
It's the woman from Aiken. What's her name?
Yeah, Maria. That Maria. Was it.
Yeah.
The one who was Robert's decoy.
I wasn't expecting that.
So, yeah. Altair is involved with a Templar. Or Templar decoy, at the very least. And yeah. They had to black it out a little, because otherwise this would get a touch R-rated. And now we have to go, because...
Where did I follow Altair here? Stuck here with Maria? Oh shit. That must be...
Yes. It certainly is, Desmond, but yes. So everyone, meet Altair's girlfriend, or whatever the assassin Holy Land equivalent of girlfriend is. Ironic, especially considering the fact we almost assassinated her during the first game. In the second to last boss,
like this,
in the second to last mission.
Hey, you okay?
Yeah, all good. Weird dreams, that's all.
All right, I'll let you get ready. See you in a few.
Ah, good of you to join us.
Sorry, long night.
What a professional approach.
Leave him alone.
Well, you'll forgive me if I want to get some actual work done.
Madness, isn't it?
Sean, please, that's enough.
All right.
Okay. Now, we're going to just go around and have a little bit of conversation with everyone before we start. Just in case they have anything else to say.
Hi.
You okay?
Yeah, I'm fine. Everything's fine.
You don't sound it.
We lost two more teams last night. That's eight more of us, just... gone.
I'm sorry.
I don't know what to do anymore. It just keeps getting worse and worse.
Hey, remember what you told me? You gotta have faith. And look, here we are, safe and sound.
For how long? And when they find us, then what?
When that happens, if that happens, we'll deal with it. I'll keep you safe.
Gosh.
Anyway, enough with my little breakdown. I should get back to work. And so should you.
I've got to antagonize Sean and talk to Rebecca first, but I'll get on it very soon, I promise.
Really, I'm fine. I promise. promise.
Okay. Rebecca? Rebecca! Apparently she has nothing to say. What about Sean? Neither of them have anything to say. Excellent. Let's just sit back down in the Animus and get back to Ezio, my preferred section of this game. Yeah, I really prefer spending as little time in the real world sections as possible, so if I'm missing things we can get to by exploration, then so be it, because in the Animus with Ezio is my preference. And we are now in Venice, and it is 1481. So, if I'm remembering right, I think that means it's been 5 years since the game started, because when we started out, wasn't it 1476? I think so. I'm going to right now take the opportunity to climb this one tower, just so we get an idea of the nearby area. $14,000 in the chest, but we won't be going back for that for a while. But yes, I almost died there thanks to clumsiness. Yes, I'm just gonna climb this one tower and possibly a few more, depending on where they're located, so that I can get an idea of the city and know what we're dealing with. And again, really, a lot of the landmarks and things in this game really are quite pretty, and I do love looking at them. The other couple of viewpoints are rather distant, so no reason to go climbing them right this instant. I can do the main quest. Hello there, Leonardo.
Messer da Vinci!
Yes?
Buongiorno e ben arrivato. I am Alice. Signor Don has asked that I escort you to the workshop. Are you ready?
Okay. We'll be coming along for the ride, apparently.
Venezia. What other place is as beautiful, as stable, as perfect?
Who is this guy? A baggage handler? Enlisted in the Navy and was tasked with defending Modon from the Turks in 1500. After a heavy night of drinking, he awoke to Turkish cannon fire bombarding his town. Panicked while running across the deck, he tripped, hit his head, and drowned. It became clear Venice had lost, was accused of negligence by the captain, and erased from the Navy's logs. Well, seems like such a fine, upstanding fellow. And not an incompetent in the slightest, doesn't he?
Behold the elegance with which she spans the Grand Canal, a symbol of Venetian unity.
And an Eagle Vision puzzle. Something for later. There's plenty of those for later.
San Giacomo di Rialto, oldest church in Venezia. Isn't she beautiful? And her clock tower, magnifico.
Yes, very impressive.
Come, come. There's more to see.
I have to be honest, one of the things that I love the most about the Assassin's Creed game is, is getting the chance to explore the architecture and see all these different cities.
Be it spices or silk, from here and
it's really nice.
There is.
You were told to stay home, but the rent is paid. I have every right to sell here.
Emilio disagrees.
No, stop.
Let us continue the tour elsewhere.
You were saying something about how this was an excellent city? I think Ezio now disagrees with that assessment. and would refer to it as another city of corrupt bastards.
Look, isn't it amazing? Would you mind buying it for me? I left my money with my bags.
Really?
Hey, mind your step, Corleone.
Were we just robbed? Fortunately not. Just genuinely bumped into, it seems. The last time that happened was that incident in Firenze that led us to La Volpe. I'm glad that wasn't the case here.
Why? What's happened?
He is attempting to unify the merchants beneath a single banner. There's been resistance. Some of it violent.
What kind of resistance?
They say they're fighting for the people, for freedom or some such nonsense. Bajanate, if you ask me.
Well, I think we'll be looking into that.
They destroyed my stand. I demand compensation.
Here you are, then.
The Doge will know about this. I'll report you to the council.
Good luck with that, my friend.
What are you doing?
You're under arrest for disrupting commerce.
What? You just invented that. There's no such law.
There is now.
No.
Wow. Just pulling laws out of their ass to arrest people. Yeah, this city needs some assassin intervention badly. That much is for certain. They really need our help if the guards are just inventing laws to arrest people. That's insane.
I present to you your workshop, Ser Da Vinci. We spared no expense in its design. You'll see, it is perfect, as if you never left Firenze. I wish you great success, and hope you enjoy Venezia as much as she enjoys having you.
Yeah, somehow I think it's not going to be quite as good as he is saying.
So, here we are. Exciting, isn't it? Care to come in?
Maybe later. I need to visit the Palazzo della Seta. Try and gain an audience with Emilio.
As you wish. But should you find yourself with free time, or another codex page, don't hesitate to visit. My door is always open.
Grazie, my friend.
Okay, then.
Di nulla.
Plus 1500? Apparently we have a codex page or two that we can get deciphered.
I found this awesome place for you to explore and practice your skills. Santa Maria dei Frari. I've marked it on your map.
Oh, is that right? Interesting. Well, let's go see Leonardo.
Leonardo! Ezio, so good to see you. How can I help you?
Codex phages.
Ah, you found another one. How exciting.
Okay.
This goes down here. I take that up there and blend it with... I've got it.
Why, thank you. There's another two deciphered pages. Now... There's a handful more towers that need climbing, so I will see to that real quick. The next two or so of them. If I can find the proper way up here. That's not it. And it's not that tower we want to climb in the first place, anyways. Now. Let's climb up here. really? Really? You people are still pulling your climbing towers is illegal nonsense, are you? You don't get to do that, bastards. If you want to come up here and get stabbed dead by Ezio, feel free. Actually, you know, I think you're going to get stabbed dead by Ezio regardless. Because
thank you.
Alrighty. My microphone decided to spend a little time on mute. So, I was trying to look for that post, but it's not as high up as I thought, apparently. Notoriety a bit.
Just let me leave it, please.
And now I will be commencing with the next stage of the main quest. I'm going to move a little bit further along with this.
How best
in this episode,
inside?
I think.
You scaled the wall and that's not good. I'll never make that jump. Need to find another way.
Thieves. Interesting. Wow. Impressive. Oh, that's not good. She is... It's hurting.
Hey.
I need your help.
I remember you.
We need to go.
You never did apologize for knocking me over.
Yeah, no. This is not the time,
wait,
Ezio.
The water.
That doesn't exactly narrow it down.
Yeah, let's get going. And yes, this is Rosa. You'll learn a bit more about her in time, but she's one of the more interesting characters. Okay, sorry for the pause and the horrifying camera angles, everyone. But I was interrupted and had to go eat some lunch, so that's what was going on there. Now let's get that one off, Rosa. Sorry, miss. Didn't mean to hit you there. But fighting in close range has a few drawbacks when it comes to things like this. And no, I don't think you'd be better off on your own. Because those guys would have torn you to ribbons if you were by yourself. I'm fairly certain of. Yeah, sorry, but no position.
All right, you bastards. Who wants to die first?
Of stay is your last.
Now I'll get you. And you. Come on, Rosa, let's hurry it up.
You'll not find better. I'll be better off on my own.
Again, we'll have to agree to disagree on that point, Rosa.
Fear not. I'll make sure each of you dies. I'll be better off on my own.
Well, that was a quick little engagement.
I want no part of this. Never break me.
Goddamn archers.
Yeah, let's hurry it up here. And now, I think we need you down. Come on.
Goddamn archers.
There. The big guy was a bit of a pain, I have to admit.
I'm better off on my own.
Come on, Rosa. Come on. Let's get out of here. Rosa, come on. We've really got to go.
Right. What's the plan?
Cristo, my leg.
Yeah, we'll have to carry you then. Well.
I never did catch your name.
Rosa.
Yeah.
Corrado, Rosa. I'm Ezio.
I know.
What do you mean, I know?
Non ora. Now is not the time.
Unbelievable.
No. I want to pick up Rosa.
I hope you weren't planning on leaving me here.
Ezio... Please, pick up the lady you're supposed to be protecting. Not the sword of one of the people you murdered. Or killed in self-defense, I guess. Please get it right.
I didn't do it. I've done other things too. I've paid the price, but not this. Mercy.
Come on now. Let's murder their faces. That's two.
What you were planning on leaving me?
No.
Hugo.
Was not.
What's this?
Rosa's been wounded.
Pass her here. We'll go the rest of the way in the boat.
Careful.
Okay. Now we're taking care of the archers. Yes. And we're on escort duty now. Alrighty. Oh. He was over here, was he? Well, into the water you go then, asshole. And I accidentally knocked them into the river, thereby killing them. Wonderful. Just wonderful. Sorry about that. I will not jump on there in future.
What the devil are you doing up here?
Kill them, Ezio, quickly!
You go down.
Get down! There he is!
Now, you die as well. Alright then. Reduce distance to target. I'll just wait a little bit for them to catch up. Say, what are you talking about? Oh, these couple of guys up ahead? So, murder you, and clear them off. Yes. Let's move away so I can do this. Now die.
They're shooting at us.
But you can also die. I can come back to loot later. Ezio, please. This is bloody ground level, you idiots. Up yours. Enjoy your time as a corpse. You fit it rather well, as it happens. But why are these people telling me to get out and constantly attacking me? I'm on the bloody ground level, for crying out loud. There's no way it's illegal to be on ground level, like they're implying. That's bullshit. It's really bullshit. But for now, I'll wait for this. Yeah, there aren't many escort missions in Assassin's Creed, but at least to me, the ones there are not that bad. They're fairly decent. They don't bother me as much as you might think. And here we are. Ezio makes it in here using magic.
Say a prayer later. I need to see Antonio.
Be careful. Let me do it. Go and find Antonio.
Sto Ugo, do what he says.
Quell'ultimo arrivato dagli ordini.
Gotta be honest, that guy's kind of an asshole.
Hey, wake up.
Yeah, don't go passing out from the pain now. My vision, my mini-map and everything has gone MIA for the moment.
Make yourselves useful. Clear a space for her. Put her down there.
Okay. Let's get to this. And the unpleasantness that is medieval surgery techniques are about to ensue.
Rosa, what's happened?
Just get this out of me.
Soon. Let's have a look first. Clean entry and exit through the thigh. That's good.
Get it out!
Rosa, we must take care not...
Now!
Come voi. Tenetela.
Yeah. This is... that's painful.
Ficcatelo nel culo, you're sorry!
Go fetch Bianca and be quick. Help me with this.
How?
Take a clean piece of linen. When I remove my hand, press the cloth into her wound. Are you ready? Now. Benfa, you work well under pressure. She's spirited this one.
Porca puttana!
Avanti. Get Rosa inside so that Bianca can close the wound.
Well, that was interesting.
Thank you. Rosa is most beautiful. If I had lost her.
Very spirited indeed.
I've always had a soft spot for women in distress.
So I've heard. Don't look so surprised. We know all about you, Ser Ezio. Your work in Florence and the rest of Tuscany. Good work, too. If a little unrefined.
unrefined.
I can guess. When you have a minute, come see me in my office. There's something we should discuss.
Okay. When I have a minute is going to be immediately.
Avanti.
Hey. We didn't even have to knock.
Can I offer you something? Biscotti. Un café.
What's café?
An interesting concoction brought to me by a Turk merchant. Here, have a taste.
Okay.
A little bitter, if you ask me. It just seems lacking somehow. I don't know. Have you considered adding sugar, maybe? Or latte?
I suppose it's something of an acquired taste.
Did Ezio just diss black coffee? As someone who doesn't put anything in their coffee personally, I am offended. I am very offended.
Palazzo Costa Stirling. It will take time to recover. No doubt Emilio will use this pause to strengthen his defenses and continue his oppression of the district. You may not share our motive, but I know you share our goal.
Why not gather your forces and try again?
To act in haste will only bring more losses. No. We must resupply and draw new plans.
Can ill afford to sit around and wait?
Nor would I want you to. Work with us instead. Already my men begin to mend today's wounds. Seek them out. They'll put you to work. The sooner you aid them, the sooner we can strike.
Molto bene.
Okay.
I accept.
It is the right decision.
Yes. And we get some money for that. Two separate missions? I'm going to do the one with Rosa right now, as Ezio wants to spend time with the lovely lady.
Hello, Rosa. You seem to be healing well.
How are you finding Venezia?
It has its charms, but how do you deal with the smell? Che schifo.
So? What brings you to me?
I was hoping you could help me with something.
And that would be?
I want to learn to climb the way you do.
Oh. Va bene, I can do that. Well, I can't, but Franco can. Franco!
Is she disappointed we didn't ask her to sleep with us?
Show Ezio how to reach the top of that scaffolding.
Wow.
Begin in a hanging position. Then jump to the ledge above you. As you reach it, grab it with your hand and pull yourself up. There.
Nice.
I think so.
Only one way to find out.
Nice.
Try for yourself.
So, this is going to let us get up a lot of those towers that I was having a little trouble with, because what we're learning here is effectively how to double jump. Is the way I would describe it. But we have to do it a specific way. Rather than just pressing the buttons as we would before. And
so,
there we are.
How did I do?
I've seen better.
Ah, you wound me with your cruel, cruel words.
All right, Smargiasso. Let's put your skills to the test.
I'm all ears.
Meet me in front of the Frari.
Okay. Let's see what Rosa has in mind then, shall we? No, not that, dumbass. And that's a little distance away, so I'm going to do the closer mission first. Even though we did just tell Rosa we'd meet her there, I'm sure we've got a bit of time.
Ah, Ezio. I was hoping you might return. I want your advice on something.
Of course. Tell me what troubles you.
Emilio has turned some of my own men against me.
Bribery and blackmail, is it?
Yes. And we cannot strike until the traitors are dealt with. They're still somewhere in this district, keeping tabs on us and reporting back to Emilio.
Not for much longer, they're not.
Yes. We have a couple of traitors that need to be killed. Something else to deal with. Now, tear this down to get rid of some more notoriety.
What is this to you? I hate you, pathetic stranieri. Always thinking you know better.
Asshole.
Your ways are best. Here, my way is to your idiots.
Well, we still have some, but there's less of it. Notoriety, I mean. Moment. Yes, now, if you're wondering what that was about, the long and short of it is that I had a pop-up that showed up on my computer. And had to deal with. And now I'm just going to wait here. And again.
Get down, Mora.
Who is telling it? Fine. Assholes.
What are you doing here?
What I am doing here is swimming around in the water. Since when was that illegal?
You shouldn't be up here. Leave.
Speaking of which, turn around and come over here so I can pull you into the water. Now, your friend over here is about to get the same treatment, provided I can pull this off correctly. There we go. That's one boat cleared of people who will locate me and offense. Now it's time to make it two. Or to just get the thief when he passes by. That as well could be an option. I need the thief over here. What was that telling me to get down? We're becoming a little bit notorious from this. I may have to see to that problem soon enough.
Eccolo! Faster! I can't see him anymore! Get down! I see him!
You son of a bitch. I was trying to stab you. Do not realize how impolite that is. Oh well. Bastard killed himself for me. That's quite nice. We didn't even have to kill him. Our target did it himself when he tried to avoid us and accidentally fell into the water.
Moving like the wind.
So that's one target down, two more to go. Get up and get back on the trail of the other two. Oh, you idiot. Tear the poster, reduce our notoriety, and head over to the next target. There he is. So that's two of them, and I didn't even have to become overtly hostile with the guards for that second one. Yes. Just fall into the water. It's easier that way. Now, let's do this. And I've got 17,500 florins right now, so very soon it will be time for me to go shopping. Oh great, it's a minstrel. Clearly, as we all know, minstrels are the right hand of Satan in this game. Because they are just evil, no two ways about it. Minstrels suck. Firstly, fix all my armor. There's two weapons I can buy now. And one small weapon. But what I'm gonna do next is finish off my set of the Hemishald armor. The metal stuff will have to wait. But this new armor should help me by making more money at home. Stop badgering me, asshole. Get the hell out of my way, minstrel. I have someone to kill. There. That's them removed from the picture. Now let's find Rosa and continue on with whatever her challenge was. Hopefully the latest person Ezio is interested in sleeping with isn't too upset by the delay. Because we all know very well that's what Ezio's interest in Rosa is. He wants to sleep with her. Because what else would he be interested in with her, really? I mean, this is Ezio. And he has precisely two things that he really cares about at this moment. sleeping with its pretty girls, and revenge for his family's murder.
Ben trovato, Ugo. What's the trouble?
You and Rosa managed to escape from Sam, but the others were not so lucky. Emilio has captured them, and now they await execution.
Do you know where they're being held?
I know they're still in the district, but beyond that, no. You'll have to look for them.
Okay,
I'll
then.
I'll have your brothers back here in no time.
Let's get to it. Free the captive thieves. And it is magically nighttime, so I'm gonna guess that this is actually not the mission we're supposed to do with Rosa, that she was telling us to meet her somewhere. Or that's something that happens later. But I'm going to say she's not going to be too offended by the fact we're really late to her meeting. As she undoubtedly knows
listen to
that
squeal.
We have important things to do.
It's no wonder their master hides.
And we have a bunch of bastards busy torturing people. The hell with it. There's no reason for subtlety here. We're just gonna flatten the bastards. Just flatten them. Make these assholes dead. Deal with them. I was trying to cut his throat, but I suppose that works too. In any case, time to murder him, so we can free those thieves and move on to the next set of them. There we go. Escort them back to Ugo. Sorry. Ezio, why do you keep doing that when I tell you to walk past the damn thing? Seriously. God damn it, Ezio. Really? Why do you have to do that? More than a little annoying. But anyways, we're just gonna head to Ugo and hope they can keep up. For the most part, anyways. I will wait when it will reduce distance to target me. That's them. Rescued? Let's find our way to the next group. Calm the fuck down, asshole. That's a little bit extreme, don't you think? Get down from there, or I will kill you. Sorry, but we have to kill you.
down to the D-line.
Oh, Nino says he seeks unity, but all he really wants is control.
Your rights cannot continue. The people won't allow it.
Yeah.
The markets belong to the people.
And I'm hearing a lot of protest in the background. I like that. I do enjoy hearing a little bit of protest. Now, down you go. So let's off this bastard real quick. Come on, just die already. And there goes another incompetent buffoon who pretends to know how to do a thing, I guess.
Quick, let's do it.
Yes. First, I'll tear that down. Sorry, guys. Now let's get ourselves out of the restricted area. Get up here so I can murder your face, please. There. Let's then put to pasture. To quote my good friend Yusuf from Assassin's Creed Revelation. Yeah, would you mind not getting in the way when I am trying to traverse? I want you behind me.
Don't worry, we'll catch you.
Hey, I am trying to climb, you bastard. And it would appear that most of... Get off there, Ezio! It would appear that all but one of my thief companions that I rescued has gotten killed. Rather unfortunate, that. I would have liked to deliver them all alive and intact, but you're bound to screw up sometimes, I suppose, so it's not excessively bad. We are going to complete the mission, just not the way I would like. I just gotta wait for him to get up here.
Stay close.
Two-thirds of the captured thieves have now been rescued. Let's use a little medicine to heal me up. If you're gonna be that annoying, then I'll just find another route. But the one thing I will say about it is that as much as the rooftop guards annoy me, at the end of the Ezio trilogy is really the last time the presence of rooftop guards makes sense. As when you get to the period of time after the Renaissance and after the 1500s, then it no longer makes sense to have guards on the rooftop to guard a city. As you can't really use the argument they're keeping an eye out in case of enemy attack anymore. That argument just doesn't work after the 1500s. So having guards on the roofs in, like, 19th century England or 18th century America is just kind of jarring because of that. Same with 18th century Paris. Although, to be perfectly honest, I've never played Unity or Syndicate, so I don't know if they do rooftop guards the same way. But I do plan to play them, and if you're about to say something to the effect of "don't play them, Unity sucks" or something, please shut up.
Better to hang their corpses from the palazzo windows.
Well, these two... I wanted to assassinate them right off the get-go. I failed because I had my sword out instead of my hidden blade. Bloody hell. Smokescreen time! We're just going to smokescreen assassinate these bastards. I can't do hidden blade counters, apparently. Which I think is kind of dumb. I don't remember which game introduced that, but I know I've done it before. It's possible it might just be one of those abilities that I haven't been taught how to do yet. I'm honestly not certain. But there they go. Now let's uncage the thieves.
Follow my lead.
I'm not involved!
And let's get out of the restricted area so we can take this approach and go on foot. No, that's water, and I don't know if those guys can swim, so let's not risk it. They might very well be incapable of swimming in terms of game mechanics. I know Ugo and Rosa had that problem in the boat when I accidentally knocked them into the water. So let's just not risk it, okay?
You're not a zoo. You won't run away this time!
Stop it. Okay. That's him taken care of, and none of them died this time. I am quite happy about that. So let's get over here and finish off the quest. Guys, hurry up.
This way.
I'm impressed.
There we are.
I didn't expect you to succeed so quickly.
I aim to please.
Yeah, even if we did accidentally get three of them killed.
I've got another job for you.
What sort of job?
Meet me near the docks, and I'll explain.
Molto bene.
Okay, then. That one's done, and we get a bit of cash for it. But I think I'm gonna have to end this episode here. These missions are a bit lengthier than I expected, so we're going to have to pick up with the Venice quests next time. So, this has been Dark Phoenix Gaming, and you've been watching Assassin's Creed 2. If you've enjoyed this, then please leave a like. Comment down below if you have any tips or suggestions, or any landmarks you especially want me to prioritize visiting or anything. And subscribe to see more like this. I hope you'll join me next time when we will be continuing some more of the main plot stuff here in Venice, and probably climbing a handful more of the towers now that it's actually possible for me to do so. So, until next time, I'll see you then, folks. I'll see you then.